Did you know that property management service companies can benefit more than any other company for memorizing and automating their normal transactions? It's true. Just watch this video, Memorizing Recurring Transactions. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Real estate management companies benefit from memorized transactions more than any other company using QuickBooks. Why? Most transactions in a property management company are the same amount each month. Most transactions in a property management service company are at the same time each month. There are very few transactions per tenant and per landlord each month. So if you don't have that many tenants or that many landlords, you can automate most of what you do. And if you have a lot of tenants and landlords, then you are making enough money to spend time on the data entry. It only takes a few seconds to set up memorized transactions. Just input the first one, like we already did, then save to the memorized transaction list. It will automatically enter the transaction as if you did it yourself. So what is our example that you will be now shown? Well, we know the monthly rent will be the same for at least a few more months. Therefore, we know our management service fees per tenant per month. We can let QuickBooks automatically enter the monthly service fee invoice per tenant each month, and that's regardless if we receive the rent or not, because no matter what, we gave the service, so we're entitled to bill the landlord for the service charge. Let's tell QuickBooks to automatically enter both monthly service invoices for Alan's tenants. Let's make automated invoices for Betty and Candy. Well, here we are, and the original invoices were here. If we take a look at the landlord payout balances, so we find the latest one, and in the case of Betty, the latest service fee invoice was right here, February 28. And when we double-click, we bring it up in front of us, and we know that this invoice will be the same in the future as far as the eye can see. It will be billed at the end of each month for the same amount. So we can memorize this, so we don't have to ever enter it again or do anything until the monthly rent changes or the service fee changes or Betty moves out. So where do you think we would click to memorize this invoice? Well, probably where it says memorize. So you have to make sure that you can see the ribbon, and in the main tab of the ribbon, click memorize. Now, you have to tell QuickBooks how often you want it. You would like this monthly because that's how you bill your client. And you want to automate the transaction. Instead of just reminding us, let's have QuickBooks do it for us. And because February 28 of 2022 was the one we're working on, that means the next time they should make this invoice is March 31st of 2022. So just tell QuickBooks to automate monthly and the next date that it should automatically make it, and you're done. When you click OK, you can check that it's memorized by opening List, Memorize Transaction List. Now here it is on the list, and if we wanted to change it, we could select it and click on it and click edit, and this would be the way we would change how it will behave. Now let's memorize Candy's invoice under Alan Arby. Close this out, close this out, close this out. Let's scroll down to Candy. The most recent service invoice for the fee was here on February 28. We double click, and again, make sure you can see the ribbon, and make sure you're in the main tab of the invoice ribbon, and you click Memorize. And again, we want QuickBooks to automatically enter this. We want QuickBooks to enter this monthly, and the date of the next one will be March 31st of 2022. And when we click OK, we can come back to the list of memorized transactions, and you can see now Candy Charles is on the list. And if we double-clicked, we would get the invoice itself, and you can edit the invoice itself. But instead, if we click to select it in the list and click the Memorize Transaction button in the bottom left, we're able to edit how we want it memorized. We can have it remind us instead of entering ourselves. We can tell QuickBooks how often to change how often we enter it, or the next date, or whatever it is. Let's close it out. And that's how you memorize transactions. So what will happen now that we've memorized these two invoices? Well, the first time you open the QuickBooks file after the next scheduled transaction date, QuickBooks will give you a message that states that the scheduled memorized transactions have been entered. We will fast forward to the next month because I reset my Windows clock to be March 31 to fool the computer into believing that it's actually March 31 when we reopen this file. You should not change the date and time in your computer. I'm only doing this for demonstration purposes, but let's imagine it's March 31 and we're about to open our QuickBooks file. So here's our QuickBooks file, Pamela Property Management. Double click and look what happens. Ha ha! We now have a message that shows that these two invoices have already been entered right here on this date, March 31st, 2022. So we click Enter Checked Now, and QuickBooks says it has automatically entered the two memorized transactions. Click OK. And if you want to check to see if QuickBooks in fact entered those two transactions, just look at the landlord balance report. Here's the invoice for Alan on March 31st, and here's the invoice for Candy on March 31st. So what else can be memorized? Well, direct deposit rent payments that the tenant sets up automatically with their bank can be memorized if you expect that the tenant will stay for several months and the rent will be the same for several months. Any other company expense payments that will be the same amount and the same time every month, you can memorize. For example, if the management company pays office rent or pays insurance payments, these are things that are the same amount and the same time every month for any type of company, and if you set them up to be memorized, you will save even more time. There is a way to speed up data entry for all other transactions by using the bank feeds feature in QuickBooks. Bank feeds means downloading the transaction from the bank and reviewing them. So what's the deal with the bank feeds feature, and how can it help a property management company? Well, property management companies can benefit more than any other type of company if they use the QuickBooks bank feeds feature. If you cannot memorize a transaction because it will not be exactly the same date and amount each month, then you can use bank feeds to set up something called rules. Rules will allow QuickBooks to enter many of your transactions automatically. So, if you use memorized transactions and bank feed rules, you will spend very little time per tenant when using QuickBooks for property management. This course will not show bank feeds. It's a separate little mini series that you can view right here on this website. I hope that you will have the opportunity to take a look, because if you combine memorizing transactions and using bank feeds, that means that a property management service company like ours should spend very little time recording transactions and doing the bookkeeping. Please investigate both options, and you will see that using QuickBooks for a property management service company really is the best option.